What's up, guys? Thanks for tuning in to another video. I want to give you the story about Anne Margaret and Elvis Presley, or at least some of the story. I came across an interview from Anne Margaret just a little while ago where she talks about that her and Elvis were actually planning on marriage. Maybe not in the plans, but they were definitely considering it and talking about it. But they ended up not going through with it because Elvis was under too much pressure from management and the public to marry Priscilla. So she says that Elvis kind of went against his heart, so to speak, to do what he had to do for his career and to make himself look good and protect his image. Elvis and Anne Margaret first met during the filming of Viva Las Vegas in 1964. Anne Margaret was starting to be very popular, especially from her movie in 1963, Bye Bye Birdie, which is kind of like a knockoff of, Elvis himself. She says, and I quote, "The connection, our connection was electrifying and we couldn't control it. We were mere images. Our chemistry on screen and off screen was unmistakable." As many of you know, Elvis and Anne kept in contact throughout their whole lives, so for the rest of Elvis's life. And even so much so, which I've just figured out, that for the 1977 TV special, Vernon actually asked Anne Margaret to represent the Presley family on that TV show, which, you know, says a lot for Vernon's respect and the Presley family's respect, at least at that time for Anne Margaret. She was one of the only ones to never talk crap about Elvis. You know, whether it was true or not, she always said positive things about him, would never mention the negative. She just always kept it positive, which I respect. She says, "We both felt a current, an electricity that went straight through us. It would become a force we couldn't control." She goes on to say, "Little did we know we shared a devil within. We were quiet, polite, and careful. But I know what was going to happen once we got to know each other. Elvis did too." I remember reading one of the Memphis Mafia books. I don't know, remember if it was Jerry Schilling's or George Klein's or one of them. Maybe it was Sonny's. Some of you I know will know what I'm talking about. So if you remember which book was from, just name it in the comments. I remember them saying that, like, Anne would visit, and, you know, Elvis would go off to his room with her and they would listen in to what they were doing, you know, having them trying to get some privacy. But the Memphis Mafia were all listening in to hearing them doing what they were doing. And, you know, because the guys were totally in awe of Anne Margaret themselves, they thought she was just the prettiest thing. So they were just totally starstruck when she was around anyway. Anne Margaret says, "We experienced music in the same visceral way. Music ignited a fiery, pent-up passion inside Elvis and me. It was an odd, embarrassing, funny, inspiring, and wonderful sensation." She goes on to say, "We looked at each other and saw mirror images. When Elvis thrust his pelvis, mine slammed forward too." Slammed? Jeez. "When his shoulder dropped, I was down with him. When he whirled, I was ready on my heel." And this I didn't know, that I guess Elvis's pet name for her was Thumper, and that was the code for her to be used around at Graceland, obviously because Priscilla was there, because this was like 1964-65, and she called him EP. Now, I don't remember exactly when Elvis got his gold phone that only certain people had the number for, which would be like Colonel Parker, his dad, Linda Thompson, all that. But I imagine if he had one at the time, she had that number. Anne Margaret's signature color was pink, and Elvis bought her a huge pink bed for her apartment in Beverly Hills. Now, this is my question. After about 64-65, when they broke up, I don't remember really hearing anything or reading anything about what their connection was after that. I mean, I do remember, I think Elvis went to some of her Las Vegas shows, but did they meet afterwards? I don't know. In the comments, let me know if you guys have heard anything about it. But Elvis, they obviously kept some contact, because for every Vegas opening that she did, Elvis would send her like a big, lavish guitar-shaped floral arrangement. And he sent it to her every opening. And she says that August 15th, 1977, which was the day before Elvis died, she didn't get that arrangement. So she called the next day and found out what happened. So Anne says that Elvis wanted to marry her, and that, quote, "his wish was that we could stay together. But like I said at the beginning of this video, Elvis had a lot of pressure to marry his longtime girlfriend, Priscilla. And, you know, pressure from the colonel, pressure from, you know, the perceived media, like what people would think if it found out that he was with Priscilla so long, like a live-in girlfriend, because, you know, it wasn't very trendy to do that at the time. And Elvis wanted his image to be squeaky clean. I mean, he wouldn't even have a cigarette in a picture until the 70s. He would always put it behind his back if he had, you know, something in his hand, you know, for a picture. So he wanted to keep his image very clean. And to him to go without marrying Priscilla this long time wouldn't have, you know, worked out for his image. So that's one of the reasons why he broke it off with her. And another reason is, I just think, in spite of what was said here, that I don't think that Elvis and Anne would have been that great of a match together. I mean, tell me what you guys think as well. I mean, Elvis wanted more of a woman that would stay home and not necessarily a career woman. You know, he didn't want a woman out on the road promoting her latest movie or music or books or anything like that. He wanted pretty much a stay-at-home wife, and Elvis wanted to be on the road. I remember reading, you know, that Elvis and her wouldn't mix as far as that's concerned, but they definitely had some feelings for each other. At one point, the press in the UK actually came out with a story about them getting married, and Elvis got really mad and accused Anne of leaking the story. So this wasn't just, you know, some rumors. This was something that was actually going to go down. And actually, Priscilla, in her book, Elvis and Me, talks about that fact that when she really found out about Anne and Elvis, that she picked up a glass vase filled with flowers, threw it across the room, hit the wall, and just shattered it because she was so angry. And think about it. She was at home, you know, trying to make herself believe that the tabloids weren't true, that what Elvis was telling her about, you know, it's just the paparazzi. They're trying to get a story going. Don't worry about it. Trying to believe that what Elvis was telling her was true. Meanwhile, the whole time her gut feeling is like, I think they're actually somewhat of an item. And, you know, this whole thing about, you know, code words for Anne around the house, and it was just a lot for Priscilla to handle. But no, I don't think they would have been a great couple, although I think Anne was, you know, a great person. I think, like I said before, like Linda Thompson said truly, that Elvis needed somebody who was from the South, a Southern girl. And that probably, in my opinion, would have been what was best for him. Elvis also needed somebody that was into God, somebody who he could connect with on a spiritual level. And I don't think Anne was really into religion, into, you know, spirituality, the Bible. So I think Elvis also needed somebody to vibe with him on that level as well. But anyway, guys, that's the video for today. I hope you've all enjoyed it, enjoyed this little story. And also, I'm not into redheads, so I never really dug Anne Margaret, but, you know, to each his own. Anyway, I hope you like this video. Hit the like button if you have. It helps to grow and expand the channel. If you haven't subbed already, go ahead and subscribe. I appreciate you guys watching. Check out my Patreon and my Bible and Fitness channel. The links are in the description below. And have a good rest of your day.